In this video, we will cover basic keying in the action timeline effects. We will focus on the first shot of the sequence. In an earlier video, we inserted a background plate of the Colosseum onto track 1 of the sequence. The green screen on track 2 was already there from the initial conform. I also deleted any old action timeline effects and added a fresh one to get a head start. Let's go into the action editor. Switch to the media menu. This menu shows all the media loaded into action that could be used for compositing. This is also the media level where you access the keying tools to key any blue or green screen shots. The selected media entry is our segment media from the sequence. In the media list, there are a few columns indicating various tools. The K column is for keying. This empty box is where you double-click to enter the modular keyer. We are now working at the media level under action, and the modular keyer contains all the keying tools. Think of the modular keyer as a super tool where you can build your own keying pipelines to tackle any keying situations. As a good starting point, there is a start mode menu where you can select a set of tools to perform different keys and rotoscoping tasks. The default starting mode in the modular keyer is using a tool known as the Master Keyer. This is one of many powerful keying tools in Autodesk Smoke. Now let's set up the layout to make it easier for you to use. Switch the layout to the 2-up view or press Option 2. Select the left view and change the viewing mode to the modular keyer schematic. You can select the right view and set the zooming to fit the view. The first step in the workflow is to remove the key color. Double-click on the Master Keyer node for its controls. Click on the key color pot and a sampling cursor will appear. Drag across the green area in the shot. When you release the cursor, the sampled green area goes gray. This gray has been keyed and color suppressed all at the same time by the Master Keyer. The result view, which is mapped to F4, shows you the output of the Master Keyer node. If you want to see the overall modular keyer result, press 4. So this is what things look like so far. The result looks pretty good, but in order to make it perfect, you need to see the alpha or matte channel generated by the Master Keyer. Press F4 multiple times until you see the matte of the Master Keyer node. You can tell what you're looking at by looking at the description at the bottom right of the viewer. In the usual tradition of keying tools and understanding mats, black is transparent, grey is semi-transparent, and white is opaque. You can see that there are issues in the tunnel part of the shot. To fix this, you can do it in a number of ways. Firstly, in the Master Keyer, you could click anywhere in the image. The on-screen sliders will allow you to adjust the different luminance levels in the alpha. Another method you could try in the Master Keyer is patching. This method allows you to work on isolated areas of the key. Under the sampling title, you can change the pull-down menu to patch 1 or press Shift 1 to choose patch 1. You can sample individual pixels by clicking on it. Or you can hold Ctrl-Shift and drag a box selection around the pixels. Notice how Smoke automatically picks the right color to add or remove areas from the mat. You can keep dragging boxes over the regions until the areas are fixed. You can also tweak the sensitivity of these patches in the sliders below. I'll just use a second patch by pressing Shift 2. And sample the black areas to ensure they are 100% transparent. If you have exhausted all the options in the Master Keyer, you could look at the other nodes in the matte pipeline. For example, select the 2D histogram node or matte edges node. If the view goes grey and says no matte in the corner, just press F4 to toggle the result view. So you could adjust the histogram or edge controls to further tweak the matte. Let's switch back to the modular keyer result by pressing 4. So the alpha channel is looking really good right now, but the colors have gone a bit strange. Switch back to the master keyer. here you will find automatic color suppression that is on by default. This is often called spill suppression in other keyers. You can adjust the range slider if too much of the key color has been suppressed. In addition to suppression, you can also color correct your keyed images to look correct. Click the Effects Node button to go to the Node bin. Press C to highlight the color correction tools. Drag out a color warper node into the schematic. Hold Option and drop it into the red front connection. Double-click on the color warper node for its controls. It looks exactly like the same color warper timeline effects. I'll quickly switch to the color warper and use the color matching technique I showed you earlier in the video about color matching in the sequence. Once that is complete, switch back to the master keyer node. Part of dealing with keying work is the edges normally land up being too bright or too dark. These edges need to be correctly balanced to match the background. By dragging the luma slider, you can see the edge brightness changing. In this case, you can darken the edges to blend with the background. So that's almost done, but I'd like to rotoscope this pillar out of the shot. Double-click on the Gmask node for its controls. Now click the viewer and press F4 to see the Gmask output. To create a Gmask, click on the Add button. You can now click and drag a shape around the pillar. Close the shape by either clicking on the first control point or clicking the Close button. The closed shape is filled with white in the matte channel. This means that the mask contents are opaque. Click on the color slider and change the value to 0. The mask is filled with black, which is transparent. To feather the edges of the mask, drag the offset slider. If you want granular control over the softness, you can switch to the tracer to access the advanced edge gradients. This allows you to feather the mask on a control point basis. The shot does move slightly when you scrub the time bar, so I'll turn on Auto Key and I can animate the mask. You can click to select individual control points, or press Command and click and drag a box selection. You can animate control points of the mask individually, in a group, or the whole shape. I'd like to mention that you could also use the stabilizer tool to track the shape. Press 4 to see the final result in the modular keyer. Press Return to exit the keyer. And press the Exit button to return to the sequence. You can now scrub the segment to preview the result. Press Render to process the final result. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.